Welcome to part one of a multi-part series on data visualization. This video will provide an introductory overview of data visualization and how to use it to tell your story. This video addresses the data visualization competency. By the end of this video, you should have a deeper understanding of data visualization and how it can be used to present data in an interesting and aesthetically pleasing way. We'll go over when it should be used, and we'll give you some examples of the different types of data visualization techniques that exist. This diagram is a visual representation of the data journey, from collecting the data to cleaning, exploring, describing, and understanding the data, to analyzing the data, and lastly, to communicating with others the story the data tell. Data visualization can occur at different steps of the data journey, depending on what you're using it for. In this video, we'll be focusing primarily on how to present data in a way that helps tell the story. Data visualization is the graphical representation of information in data. It is a combination of art and science, as it uses tools such as charts, graphs, and maps to make trends and patterns that might be hidden in a large data set much easier to understand. But how does data visualization make trends and patterns easier to understand? Vision is such an important part of how we experience the world. Perhaps because it's how we've always survived, how we found food, avoided threats, created art that preserves our culture and histories. And since the brain absorbs and processes visual information faster than any other stimuli, presenting information through graphics can be incredibly effective. So it only makes sense that as technology has evolved, so would the way we present information we're trying to share with the world. For example, think about the following question. What is the most popular kind of pie? If you really wanted to know the most popular type of pie in your hometown, you might decide to conduct a survey. This survey would ask everyone in town what kind of pie is their favorite. Apple? Cherry, blueberry, some other flavor, and finally, an option for people who really just don't like pie at all. Once you've acquired your data, there's several ways to communicate the results. The first option is text. You could consider creating a written report describing the figures that reads something like, of the 100 people surveyed, 40 preferred apple pie. 30 preferred blueberry, and 20 preferred cherry. Additionally, 5 people chose a flavor other than those in the list, and 5 said they didn't like pie at all. In this situation, where we're just trying to find out the most popular pie flavor, we might decide that reading a full analysis of the results is unnecessary. This is where the option to receive the exact same results in a table could be preferable. When reading a table, it's all about the numbers. Here, we can clearly see that most people prefer apple pie without having to take the time to read through a lot of text. So, a good thing to note here is that when you're trying to compare more than two numbers, you will probably want to look into presenting your data in a more visual way rather than textual. A third way to present the results of our pie survey is without many words or numbers at all. Option 3 is where data visualization comes in. From this picture, it's instantly clear that apple pie is the most popular. There are many different ways of presenting data visually, such as graphs, charts, maps, tables, pictographs, infographs, and dashboards. On the next few slides, we'll look at what each one is best at showing. A scatter plot is great for showing the relationship between two values. In this graph, we can clearly see the relationship between temperature on the horizontal axis and ice cream sales on the vertical axis. We can see how ice cream revenues increased with increasing temperatures. A line graph is a good way to show how something changes over time. This one shows how Canada's official poverty line has been declining in recent years from 12.1% in 2015 to 8.7% in 2018. A bar chart is better when you want to compare different groups of things. Here, we compare the use of cannabis among Canadians by age group. The chart clearly shows that cannabis use is higher among those in the younger age groups compared with older age groups. A pie chart is the perfect tool for showing the composition of a whole or the distribution of something. Here, we see that in 2018, Ontario produced more grapes for winemaking than all the other provinces combined. Here is an example of a map being used as data visualization. It shows how the job vacancy rate differs across provinces. The job vacancy rate for each province in Canada is indicated by the shading on the map. Tables are used to show many categories and provide more detail and precision than many other data visualization methods. In this table, we see the number of families with children compared to the total number of children in all families for different age ranges of children. This data visualization from the pie example is a pictograph. A pictograph is the representation of data using images. This is one of the simplest ways to represent statistical data. The popularity of different kinds of pie is represented by the number of pies. In this pictograph, each pie represents 10 individuals. While a pictograph has very low precision, our brains interpret the message instantly. An infographic is several data visualizations put together to tell a more comprehensive data story. Typically, an infographic portrays the state of something at a particular point in time, like a poster. In this example, several data points are put together to tell a story about who does the chores in a family. From this infographic, we learn that some chores are done equally by men and women, like dishes, shopping, and organizing the social life. While laundry and meal prep are more likely to be done by women, outdoor work is most likely done by men. Finally, the infographic reveals that the distribution of tasks depends on who's in the labor force at the time. A dashboard is several data visualizations put together, often to inform business decisions. Dashboards are usually updated regularly and show changes over time. The color, size, and position of the individual graphics are used strategically to focus attention on different aspects. This dashboard, for example, uses tables, charts, and graphics to display information to manage human resources. The right visualization depends on several factors. What type of data do you have? Are there relationships in the data, or are they changing over time? Are you making comparisons or showing the composition of something? And who's your audience? What story do you want to tell them? Are differences by geographic region important to them? How much precision do they want or need? Is your audience making business decisions based on the information you're sharing? Or is it simply to inform? On the previous slides, you saw some different types of data visualizations and what each one can be used for. In this video, you learned that data visualization is the graphical representation of information and data. A picture truly is worth 1,000 words. Just make sure you choose the right picture to accurately represent your data and effectively get your message across. Watch for more videos in this series featuring good practices for data visualization.